Hi, I'm Debbie Marcoux, host of the Mortgage Mom Radio Show. And why are you guys here today? Well, it's Workshop 202. What are we talking about? Well, we're going to talk about what do you do once you've signed that contract. So you've gone through all the steps. You guys watched Homebuyer Workshops 101 through 106, and you watched 201 that told you about how do you find the right real estate agent. Well, you found that real estate agent. They brought you out, they found the home that you guys want, they got you into the community you wanted to be in, the school district that you needed, the amount of bedrooms and bathrooms that you said were on that needs list that was a have to, a must have. They got you that home, you've signed the contract, you've opened escrow. Now what? Well, there's a lot of big stuff that happens right now, and a lot of people make mistakes. So let's walk you through it. It's not very hard. It's not going to take us long, but they are very, very important things to remember. So number one is that you could have started your pre-approval with me 2 years ago, 3 years ago. It could have been a long time ago. Now, we've stayed in touch, obviously, and we've had to re-pull credit reports every 4 months, and we've had to keep things up to date. However, once you get into that home and you open that escrow, the very first thing you should do is pick up the phone and call me or call your lender who you're working with. We need to know that you're in escrow. We need to know what the terms of that escrow are. We need to know, is it 30 days? Is it 15 days? Is it 10 days? Are we on a time crunch to get that loan closed? We have to know this. One of the things that's really, really important is that we've got to get your appraisal ordered. Well, we can't get your appraisal ordered until we do your disclosures. We can't do your disclosures until we talk to you. We need to talk about the loan program one more time. Make sure it is the program that you want. We need to talk about the interest rate. Do you want to lock it in? Do you want to float with the market? Are you a gambler? You want to roll the dice and hope things get a little bit better during your escrow? Or are you comfortable and happy with the payment we give you and you don't want to worry? Last thing in the world you want to have to sit and worry about on a daily basis. You didn't lock it in. So we need to do all of those things in order to get the disclosures out. Can't order that appraisal until those disclosures are out. We can't send your file to underwriting until we update your documentation. So if your pay stubs are a month old, we're gonna need new ones. If your bank statements that you gave us for your pre-approval are a couple of months old, we're gonna need new ones. Hey, did you get pre-approved in December of 2018 and now it's 2019? Well, guess what? We're gonna need new W-2s. We may need new tax returns. Depending on whether you're self-employed or you're a W-2 borrower, we will need to get some new updated items from you, even if we just did your pre-approval a month ago, or if we did it at the beginning of the year, or we did it last year. So, most important thing that you can do is contact us. Call your lender, call your loan officer, talk to them, let them know immediately that your offer was accepted. Very, very important. The next thing you're gonna do is you're gonna actually have to send in your earnest money deposit. And a lot of people get confused by that. What is this? Well, your earnest money deposit is the money that you are telling the seller, I am serious about buying this house. I am going to give you X amount of dollars. That is something that is negotiated with your real estate agent, with you and with the seller, of how much money is going to go into escrow at the beginning of the transaction. This money is applied towards your down payment and your closing costs. But a lot of times, on standard or average, we'll typically see about 3% of the sales price is what that earnest money deposit is. So if it's a $300,000 property, you're gonna need $9,000. You're gonna wire that to the escrow company and you're gonna get that there. It's going to sit there. This is going to be a refundable deposit as long as you have met all of your contingency timeframes and done everything you're supposed to do if something was to go wrong. It is a non-refundable deposit and will be released to the seller if you don't follow through on the timelines and the contingencies that you are supposed to. So there's a lot that is riding on that money. It is part of your down payment and it is part of your closing costs. But it is very, very important to get that money in as soon as escrow is opened up to show your good faith to the seller that you are 100% have 100% interest in this property and you do plan to move forward and close on this home. So that's the next step. Step after that, we need to order your home inspection. That's not me. That's where people get all confused. Your home inspection is the contractor that you're going to hire, or a physical inspector, and they're not necessarily licensed, but again, that's a realtor side, and the realtor will walk you through that. And we'll actually do another workshop with a home inspector to talk about what it is that they do on their end to help you. But you do need to order your home inspection. What are they doing? They're going to go through the property and they're going to check everything. They're going to check the pipes underneath of the sinks. They're going to flush all of the toilets. They're going to turn on all of the appliances. They're going to run the air conditioner. If there's a pool, they're going to run the pool equipment. They're going to do the very best job that they can in providing you with a detailed assessment of your home and is it in good shape. Obviously, they can't open walls. They can't put a hole in the wall. The seller's not going to have that. So they can't tell you, hey, there's a pipe that's about to break, but it's not broken yet. Has it happened that people have closed on a home and the pipes break the next day? Yeah, it's happened. But the physical inspection is a very important part of the process, and you do want to make sure that you protect yourself and get as much detailed information about that home as you can. Hey, guess what? You get your physical inspection report back and there's items on there that need to be fixed. Well, that realtor that you picked because you did your homework, like I told you to do in 201, is now going to be able to go back to the seller and negotiate on your behalf to try to get some of those repairs done prior to you closing the home. So again, that is the next step in the process. You call me, you get your money to escrow, and you get your home inspection ordered. Finally, we can't get your loan closed without your appraisal. The appraisal is not the physical inspection, and it is me. This one is me. The lender has to order the appraisal. No, you don't get to pick the appraiser. No, you can't just call random Google person, appraiser, and try to find the cheapest price that you can pay for that appraisal. It has to be ordered by the lender. But we are going to order that appraisal. We need an independent third party to tell us that the money that we're lending you, that home is worth that. So you are gonna have some upfront costs that are gonna come out of pocket right here at the beginning. You're gonna have your wire that you're gonna send to escrow for your earnest money. You're gonna have your appraisal fee that you're gonna pay to your lender. And you're gonna have your home inspection fee that you're gonna pay to your home inspector. Once you've gotten through all of those pieces, your appraisal comes back, it's at value, you've done your physical inspection, you're happy with the home, everything's great, or maybe you've had to negotiate to get some repairs done, but it got negotiated and you're happy and you're ready to move forward. We've already gotten you through underwriting at that point while you've been working on all these other things. We've submitted the loan to underwriting because you signed your disclosures. Now it's time to get into closing the loan and what do we do. I am going to do Homebuyer Workshop 203 next, and 203 is going to talk all about the closing disclosure. The closing disclosure is very, very important. There's a lot to it, and it's something that is one of the most important pieces of the loan process that you need to understand. So we are going to go through that in the next episode. So if you guys have not already, subscribe to my channel. Put some comments in the feed below. I'd love to see them and hear from you. And make sure you guys are waiting. So subscribe to the channel so you guys can see closing disclosure on Workshop 203. I hope you guys have a fantastic weekend and I'd love to hear from you. Give me a call. It's 844-935-3634. Or hey, text mom. Text the word mom to 474747. See y'all later. The Mortgage